Growth, there you are with me now, ITV News UK editor Paul Brand and Daily Mail columnist Sarah Vine. So good to see you both. Expectations were low, Paul, weren't they? How do you think she did?
I think she exceeded expectations, actually. I think as far as Liz Truss's presentational style went, this was a decent performance from her. And obviously she'd had a very, very difficult week at conference and she had to do something to sort of rally the troops on the last day of conference.
Yeah.
And I think the reason she's focusing so much on growth is because of that recession in support for the Conservative
right.
Party. And she's trying to rally them around one common message here. You know, we heard about the anti-growth coalition, the enemy outside the party. And that partly is about dealing with the enemy within, I think.
Mm.
You know, she wants to have this common enemy that the whole party can rally behind. And I think it kind of worked for her.
Yeah. I mean, it was definitely adequate.
Adequate, yes, I think so. I see. You know, if you were given a report card. But you talked about this yesterday in your column, this very thing about that she has to keep her friends close, but her enemies closer.
Exactly, yeah. She just needs to, annoyingly, and it is annoying, she does have to play the political game a bit. And,
right.
and I'm not sure she's doing that really very effectively at the moment. And the problem is that only one third of the parliamentary party, in that's to say Tory MPs, actually voted for her. She won the membership vote, but the thing is, the Tory MPs are the ones you've got to work with, and you've got to make sure that you have a relationship with them. And she doesn't really have that. And the fact that we've seen cabinet members, you know, coming out and basically disagreeing with stuff that she said, that's not a good sign. She really needs to get a handle on all of that.
So how do you do that? Because in years gone by, you would have an attack dog.
Well, one of the problems... Well, exactly. She needs. I said in my column, she needs someone quite unpleasant to show everyone the instruments.
An
enforcer.
Yeah,
she does.
Yeah.
The slight problem with her is that not only has she got rid of pretty much any minister with any sort of serious experience, she's also got rid of all the civil servants and all of the special advisers from the previous regime. So there's no one really there with any proper experience. I mean, her comms team are very young. Everyone's very experienced. Someone who was at conference was saying to me, they all look like rabbits and, rabbits in headlights. And I think she just needs to bring in some proper experience. And even if that means working with people that she doesn't necessarily agree with or who aren't necessarily completely of her sort of, thinking, I think she needs to find a way of striking a few deals and just getting some real kind of ballast behind her leadership. Because her main challenge really, I mean, I know growth, but her real challenge is being able to govern effectively. Because if you can't govern effectively, if you don't have the support of the party, if you have a party that's split, then you can't do any of your big ideas.
You can't win an election.
No, and you can't win an election either. So that's, I think that is sort of her priority.
Yeah, that's fascinating. It really is. And maybe if she'd had people around her, they would have said, don't use that song. Because the song that she came out to, Moving On Up, the lyrics, for goodness sake. But also the fact that the people, M people who made that hit are fuming.
Yeah, and the son of Heather Small is actually a Labour councillor, so the whole thing just doesn't really
work. That's an example of how she's surrounded by inexperienced people, because, to be honest, someone should have checked that.
Well, of course.
It would have been the first thing to do is to just do a quick Google and make sure there isn't a massive heffalump trap for you to fall into.
Yeah, and that lyric, Nothing Can Stop Me, she had just been stopped 2 days ago from scrapping the 45p rate, so
indeed.
That just doesn't really work.
It didn't make any sense, really. Maybe just come out to some classical music.
I think you could have come out. I mean, what you need to do is to find a Tory pop star. There aren't very many Tory pop
stars.
Can't
think of one off the top of my head.
I mean, James Blunt, maybe Mick Jagger. I don't know, someone a bit, who doesn't mind being used by the Tories. It's quite difficult. I mean,
James Blunt's not very rousing, though, is he?
I mean, he's not, no.
He would admit that himself.
Yeah.
He would be the first to admit that. She did get heckled. Greenpeace were there in the hall. They managed to get in with their banner. How do you think she handled that?
I think that was the best thing that happened to her, actually, all conference, because it really rallied the room behind her. And we see this happen all the time. I don't think heckling is the best idea if you're a campaigner, because you end up sort of turning the hall upon you.
Right.
Remember Theresa May, for example, when she got heckled in that awful speech, which all collapsed and the letters fell off the wall and all that.
Nightmare.
Yeah, and for one moment yesterday, I was wondering, is this going to be the moment where her speech starts to collapse? But no, it wasn't, because everyone rallied behind her in the hall after that.
I slightly wondered whether they'd engineered Greenpeace to come on the stage, because it did go down incredibly well in the hall. I mean, I think there's an element of also people feeling quite protective of her. I mean, she is a woman. She has had an awful week. People have been really horrible about her. And, I felt quite sorry. I mean, you do, just on a human level, you do feel quite sorry for somebody who's had such a beating.
It's difficult, though, Sarah, because we don't know her.
No.
We don't know anything about it. And it was really interesting talking to sort of like people that do PR and all of that. And they said the best thing she could do is come on here or this morning or somewhere and just have a chat.
And just be herself.
And yes, but would she be able to do that? I wonder, would she?
I think she might struggle a little bit because she's not the most naturally sort of effusive person. I mean, just that, but that's just her personality. But I do think, I mean, I do think people would like to get to know her a bit more. And you know, the process of getting elected has been so brutal and so, in some ways, so weird. You know,
it's been a strange time.
It's just
it?
A very odd thing. Yeah. It twists people out of shape. I mean, we do need to see who she is.
It's interesting, isn't it? Because she did have a bizarre start to all of this, didn't she, Paul? It was very strange because, you know, she made this big announcement and then, of course, sadly, the Queen died.
Yeah.
And that just made, you know, everything else seemed irrelevant for a while, didn't it?
Yeah, and I think the difficulty for Liz Truss is the narrative sets in very early for a leader and it will be difficult for her to reverse now all of that furore around the mini/major budget that took place a couple of weeks ago. And it feels to me as though maybe something has changed in the air now as a nation. And when you've got the momentum, as the opposition party kind of have at the moment, Labour, not that they're exactly sort of inspiring and exciting but in contrast to the Conservative Party, they're doing pretty well at the moment. It's very difficult to reverse that momentum for Liz Truss now.
I mean, the problem is that, you know, Keir Starmer just has to not mess up, really, at the moment. I mean, and it needs to be more than that.
Yeah, it does.
It really does. And, you know, for people like myself who are Conservatives, you know, it's terrible seeing the party in this terrible state, you know, because you do want it to function in a healthy way, and it's just not doing that at the moment.
No, it absolutely is not. And we know about that. We know about the cost of living and all these things. And Paul, tonight on ITV, this evening, you've got a very important documentary, actually, about that very thing.
Yeah, so we all know that the cost of living is the biggest issue pressing Liz Truss. Here I am talking about the cost of some of the basics in
just
our
basic
lives
stuff,
right now.
Yeah.
And we were talking here, actually, about whether if these items had gone up by the same amount that gas prices and oil prices have gone up, I mean, a pint, for example, would be £31. So we're trying to get to grips with just how much that inflation in energy prices is affecting the cost of everything in our lives.
That tonight, is that 8 o'clock?
Yeah, that's 8:30 tonight.
8:30. 8:30. Thank you both.
Pleasure. Great.